Eddy and I are babysitting for the weekend here. Three of our nieces and nephews, and they are just dying to be in a farming video. So we're going out to clean the milk house. Eddy's away for the day, and I feel like I say that a lot. He doesn't go away all the time, I promise. I just seem to take videos on a lot of the days that he does, but he's with one of his brothers today. So we're gonna surprise him and clean the cooler, which is overdue to be cleaned, and clean the milk house floor and get it nice and spotless. So this here is Ben.
Hi.
He's 8 years old. He's one of our nephews. This is Hannah.
Four.
You're four? Say hi.
Hi.
Hi. She's one of our nieces, and this is?
Ellie, and I'm 6 years old.
6 years old. And are you guys ready to help today?
Yeah.
Okay. And we have, these two are my kids. We have, what's your name?
Lila.
And how old are you?
Six.
And?
I want you to say it.
This is Eli, and he is also four. So hi. We've got a big crew of helpers here. Our youngest daughter, Kylie, is two, and she's napping in the house right now. So I have the five kids helping me today. You can see the cows are pretty relaxed with all the kid action in the barn. It was funny, when we first moved here, we just had the heifer barn here, but even if I went in the barn with a stroller or something when we just had our firstborn Lila, the heifers would kind of freak out and jump, and slowly over time they just react so little to the kids, like screaming in the feed alley or running around or riding scooters, like they just hardly even notice. So it's the same here in the dairy barn. The kids have been doing this since the cows have been here, so they're super used to the kids and all the sudden movements, and it's pretty nice because you don't have to worry about it startling the cows. As you can see, cows are nice and calm. Kids are yelling, scootering. Day, and I just want to show you, all the fans are running. It is super cool in here. The cows are nice and comfortable. We have fans running there to keep them cool over the robots when they're in the robots, and we have the big fans there running. It doesn't look like they're running in the camera, but they are moving very fast. You can hear them. So everything is really cool and comfortable in here. It almost feels air-conditioned. What's your best joke?
Why did the horse cross the road?
Why?
To get to the other neighborhood.
Where do you live?
Canada.
Do you live on a farm?
Yes.
What kind of farm do you live on?
Dairy farm.
What is your favorite thing about living on a dairy farm?
Riding on a tractor to see all the cows.
Having gator rides, and we go sledding with it.
Why did a cow cross the road?
Why?
Get to the moon.
We are wrapping up our week here, or maybe starting a new week, depending on how you look at it. Today's Sunday. I'm going to talk about how we approach Sundays on the farm in a bit, but I just wanted to show you here. Eddie's setting up the calf hutches now in our summer spot. We just had calf heifer number 30 this morning, so we are now putting the calves in the summer spot over there, which I'm going to show you, and then we'll clean up all this spot in the winter so that it's nice, and we will get a wagon, a proper wagon. So this here is our winter calf spot right outside the milk house door, and this is our summer spot. So we'll line them up here. That'll be the first one, or maybe, I think we usually put bull calves here. That's what we did last summer, and then the heifers went out that way. We enjoy that setup, and then the calves have a nice breeze through the summer. Part of the idea of this whole winter setup here was to shelter them from the wind, but they it's actually pretty still over here, so it would be too hot for the summer. So we'll move them over there. I'm forgetting now how we had the super hutches. I think the super hutches kind of stayed here. I can't quite remember. Again, this is only we haven't even done a full calendar year of farming here, so it's all still pretty new to us. I say this is what we normally do, but we've only done it once before, so it might change yet. We'll see. Okay, so we had three of our nieces and nephews over for a sleepover over the weekend. You just saw them cleaning the milk house yesterday. They have gone home now, and as I said, it's Sunday. We kind of just do the bare minimum on Sunday. We aren't in the fields on Sundays or doing really any extra jobs. And then we take the rest of the day to go to church. And then we will relax and spend time together as a family. Or sometimes we have family events that we go to, which is always fun. But Eddie's family is, they grew up on a dairy farm. A lot of us are still dairy farmers, so we usually do our get-togethers during the day. And then my family has nicely adopted our daytime lunch get-togethers instead of dinners to help Eddie and I and the kids be able to attend. So that's how we do Sundays here on our little dairy farm. And if you do something different, let me know in the comments what you do on Sundays. For dinner on Sundays, we always just have leftovers. When I was a kid, we always had, or not always, but we often on Sundays had like a nice roast beef dinner with the potatoes and the, you know, all the stuff. I'm from an Irish family, so the Yorkshire pudding. But then I married Eddie, and Sundays were leftovers. And at first I was like, oh, that's kind of weird. But now I get it, because you're in the barn in the morning farming, and then you go to church. And then if you have something after church, you're busy then. Then you have to go back to chores, and you just don't really have time to be cooking. And even if I do have time to be cooking, I now like to have Sundays as like my day off from cooking. We have leftovers or something super simple. So that is how we operate for Sunday dinners. How do you do it? Do you do a roast? Is that when you cook your full chicken? How do you handle Sunday dinners? I would love to know. So I'll bring you along here for our Sunday chores. Eddie is bringing out that new heifer calf, number 30. Then he's gonna go in the barn and do his feed pushing, cleaning the robots, what he normally, raking the stalls, what he normally does in the evenings, and I am going to feed these calves. Dance, 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 dance This calf here, she's in her hutch now, but number 27, Rihanna, she always knocks her feed bucket out. So we've zip tied it in, which is why I didn't take it out and mix it take it out to fill it. I'm just gonna fill it from outside of the hutch, and I just stirred it around with my hand. Eddie brought the newest heifer calf out. I don't know, I think Eli's making friends with her somewhere. Oh my goodness.
It was following me.
Okay, well, let's take her back to her hutch. You're exploring with her? Uh-oh. Let's try to get her this way. There we go. I think that might scare her if you're in there. Okay, no. Eddie has fresh milk for me. He collected it from the mama cow, from the robot. I'm going to warm it up a little bit. Well, first put it in a bottle, warm it up, then feed it to that new calf, number 30, and I have to give her a name. Milk replacer for the rest of the calves. So number 26 here is being weaned, so she just needs 2 liters of milk. And so I need 4, 8, 12, 14 liters. So then I go over here to my conversion chart. 14 liters, I need 2.1 kilograms. First, you add hot water, then cold water. So I need 14 liters of milk, but the milk replacer displaces the water. So I actually need about 12 liters of water. So I have 6 liters hot now, I'll add it. Okay, I'm gonna take this bottle over to the newest calf and train her to drink while the other ones finish drinking, and then I'll water them. Water the super hutch calves. So she drank half a bottle. I'm pretty happy with that. She had a full first colostrum feeding this morning that she drank all by herself. So what is that? Motorcycles? Some sort of race going on or something. What's up? Did you get some sand in your eye? Should we go wash it out? No? Are you guys finished over there? Can you pack up all the stuff and bring it back?
I'm not.
Okay. Okay, so I'm gonna add number 30 to the board. And we decided to name her Ulyssa the Unicorn. She was born April 16, week one. Her on Saturday, 4 liters milk, loose nipple, vaccinate, April 23. Okay, and this calf here, Rihanna, number 27, she's ready to be weaned. So I'm gonna put her on week 8, gonna change that, and I'm gonna make a weaning schedule for her. So Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. We've got 4, 3. So she's gradually weaned over 1 week. Well, that's it for today. It just started raining here. We're gonna make a dash for the house once the kids have picked up their sand toys. Yeah, thanks so much for watching. Thanks for supporting Gary. We'll see you next time.
Face shine upon you and be gracious to you.